All right, in this video, we're going to show you how to bake a texture. So now this is specific to Blender, and it works with a lot of different projects. In this instance, what I'm doing is I've got a series of videos that show you how to take a drone scan or a 3D scan, and process it through open source software, and then end up with these 3D models. So go ahead and check the different links in the description for the whole list of videos. But in this video, I'm just going to be showing you how to take a model with multiple textures applied to it and then bake it into just a single texture. And this is just used to optimize it for various reasons. Maybe you're going to make it into a low poly mesh for a game, or maybe you're going to make it into a video render, or maybe you're going to export it into an HTML file using Blend4Web. So there's various things you could do with it, but and this applies to any Blender project overall. So this is not specific to what I'm just talking about. So go ahead and take a look at this. This is going to show you how to bake your texture. So what we have here is an OBJ file output from Open Drone Map. This is a 3D scan I did on a rock. And so I've trimmed it down, but what I'm going to do is go ahead and crop it a little more, and then we're going to bake the texture on it. So instead of having all these different textures applied, you can see here these are the various materials that we have applied to this model. And so what we're going to do to simplify that is we're going to trim it down to what we want and then do a texture bake, so we have only one material with one texture file. So first I'm going to go into orthoscopic mode. So what that means is you don't see things get smaller in the distance. They stay lined up constantly. Then I'm going to hit 7 on the number pad. Yeah, we'll run it later. So now we're looking down on it. I'm going to hit tab and go into edit mode. And so I can see the top of the rock there, so I can kind of zoom in if I need to see it a little better. And I'm going to hit just B for box select. I'm going to make sure this is activated right here. What that allows me to do is select vertices behind the ones I see. Hit B again to select here. Then B again, we'll select here. B again. And then I'm just hit X and delete vertices. Okay, there we go. That gives you an example of how to crop and trim down your model, because when I first started, there was a lot of extraneous ragged edges caused by, you know, the oblique camera angles catching things in the distance. So from here, what we're going to do is form a new UV map. And we have a timeline down here. So any window in Blender can become any other window. So we're going to turn this into the UV image editor. And we're going to come over to our data object tab in the properties panel. And so here's the UV map that is currently applied. And just so you don't get too confused with how materials work, the material is something that's applied to the object, and then the texture is something that is stacked on top of the material. So it's, you can consider a stack. So back here in the data tab, make sure I'm calling that the right thing, object data, we're going to create a new UV map. So we'll just hit the plus sign, and we're going to name it Rock Bake. We'll name it Rock Bake 1 in case we end up doing more of these. And hit enter. And then down here in the image editor, we're going to create a new image. We'll call it Rock Bake 2, or Rock Bake as well. And it's better to make these POT images, or power of 2. So 1024 is a power of 2, and so we're gonna double that. If you wanted to make a smaller file for a video game or something, you'd want to go much smaller than this. But we're gonna go with 2048. By 2048. Okay, so here is our new
image that we've created. Now we're going to come back up here into our 3D view, tab into edit mode, A to select everything, U to unwrap, and then we're going to select Smart UV Project. And then we're going to accept the defaults and hit OK. And that's an intensive process, so give it a moment. And we need to make sure we're selected on Rock Bake. What just happened there, I'm not sure why it changed selection, but we need to make sure we're selected on our Rock Bake image there. Otherwise it'll cause a circular error in our bake. It'll say that there's a circular error in image texture stack. So now at this point we're going to go to the rendering tab of the properties panel. And so from here we're going to go ahead and bake it. So we're going to, which is a rendering process. And make sure you're on Blender Render for this. And we're going to look down at the bottom, we'll see bake. And a full render would take into account all the lighting in effect, and we don't want to do that. In fact, we want to, you know, before I bake this, I'm going to go ahead and save a version of it. Because this is a sort of an intensive process, and it's not unusual. I've seen crashes occur at this point. So I'm going to go ahead and hit File, Save As. I'm going to hit my Increment button and save it as Rock 3. And save. There we go. Now we're ready to make sure in our data panel we're selected on our new UV, and then in our image we got to be selected on our Rock Bake that we've created, and down here rather than full render we're going to do textures only. And then I'm going to tab into edit or object mode so you can see what's going on there, and we're going to go ahead and hit bake. And then you can see it creating the new pattern. And this is going to be all jumbled up, so don't worry about that. What has happened is we have remapped the UV to match a texture that we have not yet applied. So once this is done, the first thing we'll want to do is go ahead and save it, because this little asterisk you see by the image indicates that this image has not been saved. And you'll see the percentage indicator up there is gone, so we're done. So I'm going to go ahead and hit Save Image. Save as image, and we'll save it as Rock Bake PNG. So now that image exists in our file structure, we're going to remember we can't apply texture to an object. The texture applies to the material applies to the object. So as it now stands, all these textures are what has been applied, so we're going to make a new one. And we'll just call this Rock Bake. And with this selected, keep in mind whatever selected here is what you're going to be playing with when you go to this tab. So with that selected, oh, actually we need to apply this material to that object. And the way we do that is we tab into edit mode, make sure everything's selected, and hit assign. Okay, so now we've assigned our new material to our object, but we haven't put a texture on that material yet. So let's come over here and go into new. It's image or movie already, and so we're going to hit open, go to our Rock Bake that we have made, and open the image. Now we have a single texture applied to our object in exactly the same pattern that all those textures were previously applied to it. So if you go to material, we see that it's just this one. So now I can take that material, and let's go to our world tab. And I had previously applied environmental lighting to this to light all textures at once. And so let's turn that off, and we'll go back to the materials tab and make this material shadeless so it doesn't respond to shadows or light. And then it just lights it up just according to how the lighting was on the day. Now you can use that environmental lighting to your advantage. Let's say you fly a drone and make a 3D scan of an environment that's dark on a cloudy day. You know, sometimes you fly when it's cloudy and it's too dark. You can, instead of using shadeless, you can come to the world view and select that environmental lighting, and you can adjust that up and make a brighter day than what was really there, or darker, same way. So you can use that to your advantage, but in our case the lighting was okay when we did this image. And so we'll go ahead and make that shadeless. Alright, and so that's how you make a Rock Bake. So I'm going to go ahead and save as again. And that is how you take the multiple textures that are output from OpenDrone Map and bake them all into a single texture. We can actually look at that and compare it to the others. Here's the Rock Bake PNG that we created. So here's the new image map that we now have applied. And what was in there is, if we look at texturing, it was a combination of these. And I think, I'm not sure if all of these apply. Yeah, I think it was all of them. Or if some of them applied to one object and another applied to other, I don't know. Anyway, but I think all of these were applied. Or plenty of them anyway, lots of them. And so that way we've trimmed down our total model, and we're not utilizing that space, you know, for all those faces and for all that mesh that we're no longer using, and we're only doing a UV texture on the faces that remain. And so in a future video, I'm going to show you how to export this into HTML. What we'll be using is an add-on called Blend4Web that can export this into an HTML document in one step. So look in the description for that. Basically, once you install Blend4Web, you basically just hit File, Export HTML, and then you have a fully self-contained HTML file with this model in it, viewable by anybody with a browser. So look for that in the description. And also expect, OpenDrone Map is under heavy development, and also I'm fairly new to it, so expect updates and corrections, and I'll post those in the description as well. So do take a look at that.